Hello traders, today is the 1st of February 2011 and happy trading to you all. London is closed, New York is closed, this is the Asia session. This video is for educational purposes only. It is neither a solicitation nor an offer to buy or sell anything, and it's primarily for the TSTWSYS 008 traders. Our website is www.stochastic-macd.com, and our trading tools are the TSTW24, the TSTWSYS08, and the TSTWSYS008. Today we want to look at the Euro-USD currency pair. As you know already, we are bearish towards the Euro-USD, and in my previous video I explained to you why. But as always, when we say we are bearish, okay, we can perfectly day trade, and if there is opportunity to buy, we will buy, okay. The only time that when we are bearish we do not buy is when the market is considered as overbought. In that particular case, we will not sell, we will not buy for any reason, okay. If the market, if we consider the market as overbought, we will not look for opportunity to buy, and we will not day trade buying, okay. But if we are only bearish and the market decided to go up, as we have seen this week, the euro going up because of the oil, the crude oil rising, the euro moving in the same direction like crude oil. The scenario in Egypt now, the political situation in Egypt affecting crude oil going up, hit the $100 levels. The momentum, the bullish momentum in the crude oil is directly affecting the euro USD also, moving also into the upside, okay. And all the news coming from the United States also, the economy news are not getting very, very good at the moment, okay. So everything is working in the favor of the euro USD currency pair. But behind our mind, okay, at the back of our head, we are bearish, okay. Even though we are buying when we are day trading, we are looking for swing trading opportunity to sell the euro to the downside and to sell the Dow Jones also to the downside. Looking at this 5 days weekly chart, because I prefer the 5 days weekly chart instead of the 7 days weekly chart, because we trade 5 days in a week, Monday to Friday, okay. In my previous video I showed you this chart many times. Those who are following last can be perfectly fed up with me, because I'm showing you many times this chart. The trend line is down here, okay. And I was telling you last time that the euro, we find it very difficult to hit this trend line here. If I show you where I will place a spotlight there, that's where the market, the smart money, want to bring the euro to touch this trend line here. So previously when I did a video a month ago, we were telling you that there is a greedy target of 14,000, okay, 14,000. That's exactly in this zone, okay. Now if you want to watch those videos, you can go back and watch them, the technical analysis of the market, okay. You can watch them, and the euro, that zone is in the 14,000, but the euro will find it very difficult to touch this trend line here. Even though we see that the price is going down and then retrace to this level, so you can go and watch my previous video. So the market is trying to bring the euro to touch this level here, but in my view, the euro will find it very difficult to touch the zone there of 14,000, okay. So this is what's going on this week. The crude oil affecting the euro also, okay, so giving to the euro USD a bullish momentum. So when you are trading, that like you as a day trader, okay, you must watch the price, you must pay attention to the language of the price. If we go quickly on the, we will look first on the daily chart, okay, on the hourly chart, okay. We look on the hourly chart. Today, what we see today on this chart is quite interesting. We see this pattern of inverted head and shoulder on this hourly chart of the Euro USD currency pair, a kind of a left hand side shoulder, not the perfect one, okay, but it looks like it. And you know that the market will, trader will react to it, because most professional day traders look at the hourly chart, very important. And you see this pattern, and what they will do, they will draw on their chart, okay. The projection to here, okay. So if you do not know about the inverted head and shoulder, you can perfectly go on Google or YouTube, and excellent video posted by my fellow traders, okay, and you can learn about chart pattern and all the rest of it, okay. And they will project it, okay, to this level here. As you can see, the price hit the target right here, okay. That's where we are now, this level here. Our target for the inverted head and shoulder is hit in this zone right now, okay. So I can remove all this drawing. So if you notice this pattern this morning, okay, you will know that as soon as this level is crossed, you will be looking, you see the price break it above it and retest it with this red candle here. That's a boom to the upside. And but we notice a weakness in the uptrend, if you, because we say to you that in the morning, the first thing that you do, you draw the trend line on the hourly chart. You will notice a weakness here, because many traders knew that they should sell the euro. You see all this zone here, okay, all this zone here, there was a kind of weakness. Even though the price was above the trend line, there was a strong weakness. All the shadow here and the tail of the candle, you see people were selling here, but somebody pushed the euro out of the bearish zone. The euro escaped the bearish pressure with this candle here. Even though we have this bullish pattern, people were selling the euro here. You can see clearly here. This is the language of the price, and it kicked out and it ran away. He escaped. When he escaped with this bullish hourly candle, followed by indecision here, and the bull had to fight back and kick it away up. And since they look at that again, this zone here again, it's all again small candle. But you have to understand that the market is very, very bullish towards the euro USD right now, even though we are bearish towards the euro USD, because we are kind of a leading indicator in this market. And like I showed to you on this Friday chart, the market is trying to hit this level before selling the euro. They know that they want to sell, but they want to sell in this zone of 14000. In my humble view, the euro will struggle to hit this level here, okay. Going back again to the hourly chart of the euro USD, I will remove all my drawing here. I'll go to the 4 hour chart of the euro USD currency pair. Before I continue with the 4 hour chart, I will mention something very important for the TSTW24 traders. Well, the rule number one, okay, I hope you can remember it now. The rule number one for day trading is that you do not, okay, you do not take a signal from a lower time frame, like 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 10 minutes, hourly chart, 30 minutes. You do not take a signal from one single time frame. You will use one time frame and use another time frame for entry point. As a TSTW24 trader, our entry point time frame is the first best time frame of the TSTW24 trading system. So you can either take your signal from the second best time frame or the third best time frame, using the first best time frame as your entry point. That's the door. So when you receive a bullish signal on the second best time frame or the third best time frame, you go to the first best time frame. If you reach the first best time frame and the first best time frame is showing a strong downtrend, you cannot enter that bullish signal. On the other hand, if for instance today you receive a sell signal on the third best time frame or the second best time frame or any other time frame, you receive a bearish signal, and you are using, according to the TSTW24 rule number one, using the first best time frame as your entry point, you will notice that today you cannot enter a bearish trade. Yesterday was the same thing. You cannot enter a bearish trend because on the first best time frame of the TSTW24, we had a strong uptrend on Monday and today. Use that simple tactics all the time. Anytime you feel like selling, go to the first best time frame of the TSTW24. If it's showing a strong uptrend, do not enter the trade. Wait for the first best time frame. This will allow you to remain to trade always in the direction of the trend, that you do not trade against the trend. Today, a lot of traders were selling, as you can see, we were somewhere here, people sold it here. But if they use like us, they have the same role like us, and they try to enter through the first best time frame of the TSTW24, they will know that there is no point to sell because the first best time frame did not give us any strong downtrend today. That's the rule that you must use all the time. Use the first best time frame or the TSTW24 trading system as your indicator. If you receive a bearish signal and you come to the first best time frame of the TSTW24 and it's showing a strong uptrend, you know that you receive a wrong signal. You wait for the first best time frame to confirm that signal for you. I hope you remember that. On this 4-hour chart of the Euro USD currency pair, okay, this is the 4-hour chart. Where are we now? I'm trying to see clearly here. Okay, what we have, this is a January month. We see this kind of inverted head and shoulder, a bigger one on the 4-hour chart. Okay, so we can this one here, this one here, and this one here, and we had a failure of this pattern because no failure straight away, it fell right here. But this is in fact the first Elliott wave. For those who are following us or learning about the Elliott wave, this is the first Elliott wave. Okay, so the pattern was not directly completed where we will do a kind of projection up to here like we did on the hourly chart. So projection from here to here and then projection from here to the upside. Okay, but the price went into what we call Elliott wave pattern. That's the first wave from here to here and the second wave from here to here. Okay, but the pattern was here, and we will think that it has failed here because if you do your projection here and you try to project it here, you will think that the pattern has failed. But because it display the 5 Elliott wave, okay, so we have the because there was a pullback here, the price was in a downtrend, okay, first, and then turn around here. This zone here is a kind of consolidation zone. This round bottom here, and a higher low here give us the first Elliott wave. This round bottom is a kind of consolidation on this 4-hour chart, and then we have a higher low, first Elliott wave, second Elliott wave, and the third Elliott wave, the longest Elliott wave, okay. In this particular case, it looks to me, you can perfectly disagree with me because this is not a science, okay. This third Elliott wave has been divided into 5 waves. We know that the first Elliott wave and the third Elliott wave can be perfectly be divided into 5 waves, okay. The first Elliott wave, the third Elliott wave, and the fifth Elliott wave can be divided into 5 small waves, and the second Elliott wave and the fourth Elliott wave can be divided into ABC corrective move. So we have here, okay, small, okay, wave within this third Elliott wave on this it's not very clear, not perfectly built, I have to say, but I try to draw it for you. You may, this is not a sign, so please accept that, okay. So we have our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave within the third Elliott wave. What I will do, okay, this video is for educational purposes only. Is neither a solicitation or an offer to buy or sell anything, okay. What I will do, I will color all this line for you so you can see what I'm talking about, that the first Elliott wave, the third Elliott wave, and the fifth Elliott wave can be divided into 5 Elliott wave. That's what we call the complex Elliott wave, okay. This is one example where the third Elliott wave is a complex Elliott wave, Okay, so I'm just here trying to put a different color here for you. Put a pink one for the ladies, okay? And also which last color here, turquoise, okay? So first wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, fifth wave, and this third Elliott wave has been divided into a five wave. This is a typical complex Elliott wave. In some of the previous video, I show you the ABC corrective move within the second Elliott wave and the fourth Elliott wave, okay? So then we have here, okay, the fourth Elliott wave, okay? And then now we are at the end of Elliott wave cycle, okay? We are expecting, like I said to you, we are looking since last week for opportunity to sell the Euro USD. We are bearish, in fact we are bearish, which means we want to sell the Euro to the downside using the swing trading method. We will enter the trade with the TSTW SYS 008 or the TSTW SYS 08 or the TSTW 24. Okay, so this is the fifth Elliott wave. If I call up my main Elliott wave for you, what I will use, which color should I use now? I will use. I will use white for all of them, so you can see what I'm talking about. This one I will use instead yellow for this one because it's near, and then we'll use again white one here, okay, and then I will use again another white color here again, and then I will use again another white color here again. So this is it on this 4-hour chart. The first Elliott wave from here to here, okay? The second Elliott wave from here to here, the third Elliott wave from here to here, and the fourth Elliott wave from here to here, and the fifth Elliott wave from here to here. End of Elliott wave cycle. The third Elliott wave in this case is a complex Elliott wave which has been divided into five small waves. First wave, second wave, third wave, fourth wave, fifth wave, okay? So we are at the top of the cycle now. What we are expecting now is for the price to give us what we call the ABC corrective move, okay? The point that you need to watch out for is this level here. I will draw horizontal line there for you. This level, this support level here, this is the last higher low, okay, in this cycle. The last higher low is a very psychological level, which is the end of the fourth Elliott wave, where I draw my horizontal line, this level of 135.70. If this level is taken out, we are now completely bearish. Repeat, if this the price went below the 135.70, repeat, very important, as soon as the price break below the fourth Elliott wave and the final resistance below that level, which I draw here, I will color it instead red for you so you can see. If the price come back from the fifth Elliott wave and break below the low which was formed at the end of the fourth Elliott wave right here, and the final resistance below that level of 135.70, we are in a bearish zone, okay? So we are expecting the price, according to the Elliott wave theory, to display what we call the A, okay? Okay, the A, B, C, okay? Something like this. Okay, ABC, the ABC, okay, corrective move, okay, that will bring the price somewhere according to Elliott wave. Usually, if we use the Fibonacci, it will bring the price in the region of 61.8, okay, 61.8 Fibonacci retracement level, okay, the ABC corrective move, in most cases, okay, will bring the price, okay, to the 61.8, okay, Fibonacci retracement level. The 51.8, the 61, the 61.8 Fibonacci retracement level is the line of the whole uptrend, the uptrend that has started here, where the first Elliott wave has started, the whole uptrend from here all the way up here, the ABC corrective move according to Elliott wave, in theory, in most cases, will bring the price in the zone of 50% and 61.8, okay, Fibonacci retracement level for you, okay? What I will do in this case, I will draw the 50%. The 50% is the line here. I will color that line yellow. Okay, that's the 50% of the whole uptrend. That's the yellow line here. And okay, the 61.8 is this one here. Okay, I will color that one perfectly blue for you. So the ABC, okay, corrective move has a tendency, okay, will bring the price into this zone here. This zone here, we can perfectly put a spotlight there, okay, in this zone here of 13400, okay, between 13380 and 13469. 13380 and 13469. Okay, the euro is at the end of the fifth Elliott wave right now. As I'm speaking to you, okay, the best thing to do, this is the pole position, to sell nicely with a tiny stop loss with 30 pip, 30, which means you are not prepared to close the trade. You remain in the trade. You do not allow anyone to bully you. You remain in the trade. If the price decided to go up and take you out, that's perfectly okay. But in this condition, after counting the fifth Elliott wave, if you are selling here, you are not prepared to close the trade for any reason. You are willing to be taken out if the price is about to go above. So you use like 30 pip, which is 30 stop loss, if the price kick you out. All you can say is ouch. You do not call your mother for this loss if this happened to be a loss. The best thing to do is to wait for the TSTWSY08 or the TSTWSYS008 to give you a perfect entry point. Or for those who are not using our tool, if you hit this level, you switch to the lower time frame. For those who are using a TSTW24, waiting for the TSTW24 on the first best time frame to confirm a strong downtrend, and then you enter, so you know that the downtrend has begun. Okay, so this is about the euro USD currency pair. We are perfectly bearish towards this currency pair, but as I said, if the music has changed like it did today, the dance must change. Okay, so to summarize quickly, we have the five Elliott wave on this 4-hour chart for you. You may perfectly disagree because this is a theory, it's not a science. Okay, so first wave, second wave, third wave, okay, and fourth wave, fifth wave, end of Elliott wave. Opportunity here, one must look for opportunity to sell. A target in the zone, first target is 13570, which is the end of the fourth Elliott wave. As soon as we go below the 13570, we are perfectly bearish. If the price find a resistance below 13570, that will confirm the bearish pressure for us. And the target in the zone of 13469, even going down below to 13380. That remains to be seen because there are a lot of news. As always, the news can change the market move, the sentiment. There are economic news, there are political news. The situation in Egypt can affect the crude oil, and crude oil can affect the euro. Nothing remains intact in the market. This is a technical analysis. One must pay attention to the fundamental, to the news, and to adjust when you are day trading. If you are day trading and you are not prepared to be flexible, to adjust to the changes, you must well look for something else, okay? That may be tough to say, but this is the reality of the market. To accurately, okay, know exactly what's happening and make the right decision. And if you see that the music has changed, quickly change also the steps, okay? So I hope you enjoyed this video, that you will put it into practice, okay, in order, okay, to cream the market consistently. We are the TSTWSYS008 traders. Thank you for watching, and speak to you soon.